Welcome, dear Odooers. As a sales manager, it gets challenging to manage more than 15 salesmen. The bigger the team, the less time there is to train people and support them on larger deals. That's why at Stealthy Wood, we decided to split our salespeople into smaller, more manageable teams. The most common approach is to make the split based on localization, by countries, regions, or cities. This way, a group of customers sharing the same language, habits, and cultural background will be in contact with the appropriate and dedicated sales team who understands their needs. Another approach would be to split the team according to market segments, such as the customer's profiles or the products they buy. For example, a company could have a sales team responsible for their B2B activity, selling to other companies, where another team could deal with the customers of their B2C activity. As these activities have different sales flows, it makes sense to separate your sales teams. For instance, here, my second sales team will only have two stages before closing a deal. For recurring sales, you could also split the salespeople according to their sales personas, between hunters and farmers, which are two different sales profiles with different sets of skills. Hunters are always looking for new leads and in charge of acquiring new customers, while farmers focus on building long-term relationships with the existing customers. For example, a direct sales team composed of hunters could acquire new customers and assign them afterward to a customer success team of account managers who have the purpose to upsell in the long term. Since it's seven times more difficult to attract new customers than selling to already existing customers, the direct sales team gets a higher commission rate. So let's look at our sales teams in Odoo's CRM app. All right, so here I am looking at my opportunities in the CRM app. But what I'm going to do now is actually check out my sales teams. So I'm going to go to Configuration, Sales Teams. And I've already created two, one for Europe and one for America. Those are where our Stealthy Wood offices are located. So let's go ahead and check out the sales team for Europe. Okay, so I'm going to click here. I'm also going to click on Edit. All right, so of course I've given it a name. And I've also said that I would like to be able to create some quotations from these opportunities, the ones assigned to the sales team. And also I want to have a pipeline for this opportunity. Okay, I can even choose a team leader. So let's go ahead and make myself the team leader, Amy Caroline. And I can also choose an email alias. So this is really cool. Anytime someone will send an email to this email address, it will be converted into an opportunity and then added to the pipeline for this team. Okay, so I've already created one and I will show you that in just a moment. But let's go ahead and talk about some of these other fields. So we can say who we will accept emails from. Okay, so we can say only followers, authenticated partners, or everyone. And I'm going to say everyone because I do want to have those opportunities coming in. Okay, and then I can say who I would like to assign the opportunities to. We have an invoicing target, and I can also select a specific company if I'm in a multi-company environment. All right, I can add some team members as well right here. So let's go ahead and add Julian to the team. Okay, and then we're going to save. All right, so now that I've done that, let's go ahead and check out our team pipeline. Okay, so we're going to go to sales, team pipelines. All right, I'm going to see both of those pipes right here. Okay, mine on the left for Europe and on the right for America. And I'm also going to be able to do a cool few things from here. So if I click on these three little dots, I'm going to have some different information or actions that I can do. So for example, I can view quotations for this team, sales orders, invoices, of course, opportunities as well. I'm also going to be able to create a new quotation or opportunity from here. Okay, I have some reports on the right as well, and I can even color code these pipelines. Okay, so maybe Europe will be this kind of pinkish color and America will be yellow. Okay, so now let's go ahead, enter the pipeline and check out that opportunity I created by sending an email to that email address that we saw on the sales team configuration. So I'm going to click on pipeline. Okay. And this is the opportunity right here. It's in the new column. Okay, so modular desks. I'm going to select this and click on edit. Now I sent the email and the subject of the email was modular desks. As you can see, that has been converted to the title. Okay, and the body of the email will be noted in the chatter. All right, we have that right here. Okay, we have the email of the customer, of course, since they sent the email. And then we also have some other information. The sales team is automatically assigned because they emailed that one specific email that was the email alias for that team. So I could have set that alias to be sales Europe at my company, odoo.com. And then for the US, I could say salesusa.odoo.com. However, in this case, I just said sales.odoo.com. Okay. So we also have some other things which we can add manually, such as the expected closing, tags, company, and more. And I've talked about that in another video, so be sure you check it out. So let's go ahead and save this the way it is for now. But actually, I want to be sure that I nurture this opportunity. I don't want to forget about this person, so I'm going to schedule some activities for myself. So if I go down to the chatter, all right, and if I zoom out, I'm going to see the chatter on the right side of the window rather than below the opportunity as I have here. I can schedule an activity. So if I click here, all right, I'm going to have the opportunity to, let's say, schedule a call for this person, okay? And then I can write some notes if I would like to, a summary, and perhaps I don't want to be the one who calls the person initially. I want it to go to one of my colleagues. I can assign it to someone else. Okay? And I can even add a due date. But we're actually going to discard this for now. And we're going to check out our activity types because I don't want to just schedule an activity each time. I want to add some automation to this. So we're going to go to configuration, activity types. Okay, so actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my activity type, make quote. It's right here. I'm going to edit. So when we do that, we have some options. And of course, we can always create some activities as well. And it's quite simple. You just have to click on the create button. But let's edit this one that we have here. So first of all, we have the name, make quote. It's pretty self-explanatory. All right, we can even add an action to perform, such as upload document, meeting, but I'm going to leave it as none. We can add a default user, a default summary, default description. Okay, we can even have a scheduled date after the previous activity deadline. Okay, we also have another really cool option that's trigger next activity. Okay, so that means that when I'm done with this, I will be able to trigger the next default activity right away. All right, so you can see I have that next that default next activity here, which is not a mandatory field, and we know it's not mandatory because the line is not in bold, but if I select this option, it's going to become mandatory. Okay, I'm just going to remove this for a second so I can show you some of these fields that disappear when I select it, such as email templates, which we can add here. And we also have recommended next activities. So if you don't want to have a default, you can say, okay, you just made a quote. So how about you schedule an activity for a follow-up call or follow-up email? You can do that right here. But let's go ahead and trigger the next activity. And the next activity, the default next activity, will be follow-up quote. Okay, so that's logical. Follow-up quote comes after the first quote. Okay, so we're going to save. All right, I'm going to go back to my pipeline by clicking on CRM right here. And I'm going to go to that opportunity. And I have to be sure that I correctly assigned it to myself, which I didn't. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Okay, salesperson Amy Caroline, save. Now when I go to my pipeline, it will be there right here. Okay, let's schedule that next activity. All right, so we can make the quote. Let's make it today. Schedule. Okay, now when I mark this as done, I'm going to have the button done and launch next. Okay, so I don't have to do anything else. Done and launch next. Now I have that second activity, which is due in 45 days. And since this one doesn't have a default next activity, once I click mark done, I'm going to have my regular options. So I can select done and schedule next, or just be done, or discard this. So it's really easy to be sure you're following up with your customers, and as I said before, really nurturing these opportunities. And you can customize it to your business's needs. Again, if we go to our activity types, you can easily create a new one and customize it to what your business or your salespeople need. All right, so now that I've done that, let's go ahead and check out our reports. So if I go to reporting, I can look at the reports for my pipelines. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select that right here. And I can change the measures and also how I group. So let's go ahead and measure by expected revenue. Okay, and then I'm going to group by my sales team so I can compare the two sales teams, see how everyone is doing. All right, we have sales team here. But not only that, I also want to change the time range. So I'm going to go to time range at the top right here. And I would like to say the last 7 days, and I can apply, but not only that, I want to compare the last 7 days to another point of time or another period of time. So I'm going to go ahead and say the previous year and then apply. And we see all of that data changing right before our eyes. It's so easy to keep track of what's going on. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. And if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.